Yes, I mean, the act of voting in the largest democracy in the world is obviously a very unifying thing.
Yes.
The question is, you know, I mean, the importance of voting. I mean, and is the most important thing that you can do as a citizen of this country. I think young people notoriously do not vote. And I think that is the reason we've been brought here today, is to speak at this forum to try and influence and point out the importance of that vote today. And living in a democracy, that voice you have, that importance you have to effect change is the most important thing. And I think that unity and that awareness of that democracy is why we're here. So, you know, good afternoon, everybody. And thank you for that question.
Yeah. As you said, it definitely is the largest festival that all of us can come together and celebrate, irrespective of our religion, caste, creed, color, etc., etc.
Yes.
You know, I believe you're going to have around 900 million
voters
this year.
Yes.
And I think it's amazing. And yes, it's a festival, but that, and it's a holiday. That doesn't mean that you sit home and chill. You know,
it's
you
a
have
long
to be,
weekend, guys.
Yeah, and you can't. You have to be responsible about the fact that we are in a democracy. Our constitution has given us the right to vote, and we have to exercise it with a lot of responsibility.
Yes.
You know, we are the people that are going to choose our government. The government is made by us, for us.
Yes.
You know, we have to make sure that we have the right people in a place of power.
Yes.
You know, that are responsible and that love our nation as much as we do.
Definitely.
You know, so definitely it's a festival, and we need to celebrate it, and we need to be proud of it. We can't be negative ki, you know, kya fayda jaake vote kare, ya, you know, what's the point of going and voting. No, it's your duty towards your country.
You should.
Well, kafi tadad mein log aaye. I see some empty seats, but I hope this doesn't happen on the voting day. So guys, please go vote, because do it for yourself, yaar. It's like a dressing on your burger, maybe, you know. And if you don't choose that, you won't like it when you eat it. So choosing your country, you're making your country. You guys, you know, for all the things you wait to do when you turn 18, I think one of the most fun thing is to do is to make a country, which you'll remember when you're old. And you know, so just do it, guys. It's choose your leader, choose your government. And yeah, and just 29th of April is also speaking about holidays. Yeah, don't do that. I know you can vote and go have fun, chill, play some games, watch IPL, do whatever you want to. But please vote. That's the priority, and that's you know, do it for the freedom fighters who have you know, fought for our country and visioned you know, an India where you know, they wanted to make this India great.
Yes.
Sone ki chidiya, as they say. Get it back again, and it's in our hands. Hum nahi karenge to kaun karega? Over like I think around two-third of the population is under 35, so it's the youth has a very important role to play. It's our duty, it's our responsibility, and our right to choose.
Completely
the one who leads our country.
Yeah,
exactly.
And even one vote is important, right?
So
I mean, I think not voting should not be an option.
Definitely.
And, yeah, and you can really affect change. People will fear. I think one of the things that any government or any leader should fear and be really aware of is the power of unity, of union in this country. Like if you get together, if you get a student union body together and, you know, decide and discuss and decide you can vote one way or not, suddenly you become really important people to these guys and they'll fear you. So use that and look after the country we live in.
Awesome. Mr. Jugi, you want to add something?
Yeah, I just want to add, you know, again, it's 900 million voters. It's 400 million young voters, 1 million booths. You know, that's 29 states, 7 union territories. So it's a country which is really vast and very, very big, the biggest democratic setup. And, you know, when you look at, so this is a national election, but when you look at elections over a period of time, whether the state elections or what, you know, wherever people have really come out and voted, you've seen the evolution happening, the change happening, and, you know, a sort of a revolution happening. So it's very, very important for us to understand that the power of vote, even one person really, you know, makes a lot of difference, and we need to realize and contribute towards it.
Saif.
So, well, you know, I think it's also about mindset. I mean, we came from a time, I did a film on that also, where, you know, you kind of had to follow a certain career path many years ago. I mean, following certain things was not an option. Even frankly, becoming an actor was not always the most attractive option for certain people and families. That's be a doctor or a lawyer and that kind of thing, and you're educated accordingly. And today, like you said, about whether it's weightlifting, all these things, it's also a question of options and mindset.
Definitely.
That's come forward.
Yes.
And that's the biggest change, and that discussion and that awareness that young people will bring to that.
Yeah. They could take their mindset forward and make sure they're doing what they're really passionate about.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes.
So yeah, the idea is to find a passion and to kind of use that to effect whatever positive change or that you can in your universe, in your sphere, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, our youth is our future, right?
Yes.
With the way the world is connected today, we automatically have realized that, okay, we are lacking certain things in our country, but you just can't blame the government for it. We have to individually take some responsibility and make sure that we can bring about certain amount of change in our own way.
You
know, it can be something as simple as convincing the people that work for you, your staff, that, you know, you must go vote, or you must be responsible about the way you use water, or, you know, burning crops is not the best way of getting rid of, I mean, it causes air pollution. I mean, on a very individualistic level, we need to bring about a change. And I think that's what our youth has realized.
Yes.
You know, you have so many portals, like the one that you run, right? Where you are constantly bringing out constructive stories about what we as Indians are doing to bring about a change.
Yes.
You know, the internet obviously is a great boon. It has helped us a lot. It has helped us kind of open up our minds and see how our country can just become better. You know, we've realized that, okay, we can't have an ostrich mentality. We need to understand that, okay, this is a situation that we are in, and if we don't take strong actions against them, shit's gonna go down.
Yeah.
You know?
Yes.
So, and I feel we are the ones that can do it. We have to do it for future generations to come. We have to do it for our current situation.
Yes, we do.
And the youth has all the power, You know, they have to, as Sir said, I think we have about 400 million young voters.
Yeah.
That's a huge number. And I truly, truly hope that all of them go vote, because you've got to be the change that you want to see.
When you look at youth, it's really bringing in a lot of change, whether you look at the new startups, whether you look at, you know, the things which are happening around the country. I was reading an article 2 days back which mentioned about a young lady who has started a surfing community in a very small village town near Mangalore.
Yeah.
So, you know, these are very, very inspiring stories. Imagine setting up a surfing community and providing livelihood to nearby villages. You know, telling each villager that, you know, your family, if it takes care of, let's say, a tourist who comes and, you know, you offer them meals and accommodation, that is how you earn better, you provide education to your kids, and you, the whole community, the whole village evolves.
Yeah.
So, you know, they're really very, very interesting stories. And even when I talk to my son, you know, he's 14 years old, and if I tell him that, okay, this is what I'm thinking about you, he says, you don't think about me, let me think about myself. You know, so this is the kind of change. And when you see such a vibrant youth and such an empowered youth, you really feel blessed that you're in a country where the youth is very, very active and is willing to participate and willing to contribute towards the progress of the country. And I feel, you know, the biggest contribution which is required is now, when the biggest democratic setup and, you know, the voting is happening.
Working, and it's clean overnight.
Versova Beach being one of the greatest examples.
Yes.
I mean, I've lived there all my life, and I remember there used to be a heap of kachra on that beach, and literally bi-weekly people come together and they themselves collect all of it. And obviously we have the government, we have the municipality officials also, they've also joined the movement.
Definitely.
And it's just a very great initiative of keeping our city clean.
Yes. Yeah.
You know, of all the garbage.
Yeah, definitely. Mr. Chugi, want to add something?
Yeah, so when you look at, you know, one is, you know, on the space front, the kind of initiatives under different governments and the kind of, you know, leap we have taken on the space front, which is really phenomenal. Today, different countries are asking us to launch their satellites, which is really phenomenal achievement. Again, through various initiatives during different governments, when you look at 2020, we would be having at least 700 million smartphones.
Yes.
Can you imagine the kind of digitalization which
Definitely.
Has happened over a period of time? So it's really phenomenal.
Smart people, not smartphones.
In villages,
smarter people, smartphones. Yeah.
Smartphones are also making people smart. Yes. Go ahead, Bhumi, sorry.
You know, I shoot extensively in rural India. You know, my films are such. And it amazes me how all of them have a smartphone, but they don't have toilets. Now, this is a thing that's kind of close to me because I've done a film around sanitation. And just speaking of development, just how much we've progressed where the sanitation bit of India is concerned.
Yes.
And again, getting the whole feminism or women empowerment angle to it, how women now have the courage to kind of fight any kind of prejudice that comes their way, from sanitation to education to illiteracy to dowry to feticide. I mean, this definitely, we've come a long, long, long way since our independence.
Agree.
There are such amazing stories that we've come through. Sorry, sir. No, no, please.
Even the Me Too movement.
Yeah. Absolutely, the
yes,
Me Too movement.
Definitely.
I mean, who could have thought that a few years ago, if a girl would have done this, she would have been ridiculed.
Definitely.
Today, she is encouraged, she's given power, she is celebrated, and she has motivated a lot more people to come out in public with their stories, and it is just amazing. I, as a girl, feel a lot more secure today. You know, when I think of all the stories that my mom told me, or all the incidents that my aunts or people in my family or people that I know of went through, I feel like, okay, we are in a better place, and I really hope that the future generations feel a lot more secure.
If freestyle can look this easy, I don't know what prepared style looks like. This was awesome. Thank you so much. So,
what a freestyling, I mean, yeah.
We'll go to talking about how we all said, right, every individual has the power to do something and create an impact in the country. So I want to ask you guys, how do you think, what kind of work can you do? How do you plan to work towards making India better by, say, 2024? Saif, you want to take that?
You know, I think applying things that we talk about in a more active way, whether in all spheres of life, you know, like you say, like spreading and practicing knowledge and awareness, you know, behaving a bit more green, you know, things like this, like practical application of these ideas.
Definitely.
You know?
Definitely. Bhumi?
I think just by becoming a good example for your ecosystem, you know, just adding to what Saif said, being more responsible towards your environment, being a better human being, showing compassion towards others, showing empathy towards others, I mean, we need to get out of our bubble, you know, especially the urban classes, because we have a certain amount of comfort that maybe other parts of our country don't. And we need to realize that we are in a place of privilege, and we shouldn't take that for granted.
Definitely.
You know,
sorry,
so
can
if
I just add to something I'm saying?
Please.
Just like, I think to be aware what an Indian citizen is, basically, right?
Yeah.
What does
it
mean? To do a little thinking, really, what it means to be an Indian citizen and how to apply that, speaking generally.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Make them aware of whatever about our environment or wildlife preservation or the forests. It could be through this, and it will only happen if we expand as an industry and not only focus on the commercial films, but also make films which are very, you know, socially relevant.
Sure.
So that will only happen if we, you know, we need more theaters, we need film schools, we need to give voice to our people. You know, like there's a song in Gully Boy called Azadi, which is about how, you know, the Sarkar and there's a song in Sacred Games by Divine, ki raaste mein khaddi nahi, khaddo mein raaste hain. Chhati hai chhodi kyunki Bombay har saas mein. But that's what it is. Like these are, you know, one-liners which stick with, and but you know, you're getting aware. You, and you, if you think about